Hello everyone, welcome to Pins and Bobbins. I am Tripta and today in this video I'll be showing you how to make a shirt bodycon dress. This video is special as I have made this dress for my daughter. So let's quickly jump into the video. For making this shirt bodycon dress, I have taken 2.5 meters of this colorful georgette fabric, but you will take any fabric of your choice. I have taken the following measurements for this dress. Shoulder at 5.5 inches as I have taken half of front. That is, upper bust is 11 inches and I have taken half of it. Arm hole at 7 inches and mark my bust at 32 inches and waist 26 inches, hips at 35 inches and mark quarter of them. That is 8 inches, 6.5 inches and 8.75 inches. Length of dress is 33.5 inches and now I am marking 2 times of all these measurements. That is, shoulder at 11 inches, bust at 16 inches, waist at 13 inches, hips at 17.5 inches. And armhole will be same at 7 inches. So this is my basic bodice with the given measurements. I have taken 2 times of the given measurements. For example, bust is 8 inches, so I have taken 16 inches. Waist is 6.5 inches, so I have taken 13 inches. Hips is 8.75 inches, so 2 times of it is 17.5 inches. And length of dress is 33.5 inches. So everything is 2 times except armhole and length. And I have taken shoulder at 5.5 inches. So 2 times of it is 11 inches, but armhole will be same at 7 inches and we'll take 1/3 of armhole, that is 7 divided by 3 is approximately 2.5 inches, but I am taking 1 inch extra for seam allowance and it becomes 3.5 inches and we'll cut from here. So I have taken seam allowance both on top and bottom and now we'll cut it. Now cut the pattern on fabric. And now we have to shirt this. But before that, hem the top of both the panels. Double fold the fabric and give a stitch on both the panels. I have done it. Now start marking the line so that you can be neat on your lines on fabric while shirring. There is already a detailed video on channel about shirring and the link is given in the description box. You can check it out. And there are some more videos on channel about shirring. If you love shirring like me, you can check them also. For shirring, I am using the pattern like from top. Leave an inch gap and then mark 2 lines on half inch gap and then leave an inch gap. And again mark 2 lines on half inch distance and then leave an inch gap. So I have done it. And now we'll follow these lines as in guide. But before that, set your stitch length to the highest on your machine and change your bobbin from normal thread to elastic thread. And always remember to do a back stitch when you start and stop for a secure stitch. Now I am done with shirring on both the panels of front and back. Now keeping right on right, match the armholes and join the sides. Give a stitch right below the armhole to all the way down. And do this on both the sides. So I have done it and done the finishing as well. Now hem the bottom. Double fold the fabric and give a stitch. So I have done it and with this I am done with the bodice part. And now we'll move to sleeves. For sleeves I have taken 2 times the measurement of biceps as this is the highest point on sleeve. So in my case the biceps are 9 inches. So I am taking 18 inches on fold. So this is my folded side and this is the selvage. And length of the sleeves I have taken, that is 22 inches. So length is 22 inches and width is 18 inches on fold. For armhole on sleeves, I have taken 3.5 inches on length and 1 inch extra for the elastic casing, which in totals became 4.5 inches. And width I have taken 2.5 inches. Now join the points and cut it. So these are the two sleeves. Now hem the top of the sleeve to create a tunnel for 1/4 inch of elastic. Double fold the fabric and give a stitch on both the sleeves. I have done it, and now for sleeves too, we'll follow the same lining pattern for shirring as we have done on bodice. That is two lines on half inch gap, then leave an inch gap and repeat the same and leave 5 to 6 inches flounce on bottom of sleeve as per your choice. Now let's start shirring again, but before that, change your normal bobbin thread to elastic thread. So I have done it for both the sleeves. And now we'll pass elastic from this casing. Take 1/4 inch of elastic. I have taken 8 inch long elastic. But for this, the measurement can be different for everyone. So please check it on your body where you feel comfortable. Now with the help of safety pin, pass the elastic from the tunnel and secure it with pins temporarily. Then give a zigzag stitch on both the ends of both the sleeves. So I have done it. Now fold the sleeve and give a stitch right below the armhole to all the way till here on both the sleeves. So I have done it and done the finishing as well. Now hem the bottom of sleeves. Double fold the fabric and give a stitch. So I have done it for both the sleeves. And now I'll join it to the main bodice. Now pin the armhole of dress and sleeves together, as pinning always helps. Keep the sleeves as right facing right on dress and pin along. Now give a stitch on both the sides. So I have done it off camera and done the finishing as well. And this is the final look of this dress.
So hope you guys like it. Always remember to give a thumbs up. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Follow me on other social media platforms. I'll be coming up with this tiger print dress next week. So stay tuned. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.